Well, I've just been informed that my gear is not appropriate, which is not too bad of a thing considering I'm right here at the black market. Well, regardless of whether you're a Mongolian living in the countryside and decided to come to town here, whether you're an international tourist, if you've just landed in Ulaanbaatar, chances are your first stop is going to be the black market here. This black market is one of the oldest in Asia, and it's been here for around 20 years.
These are the material silks that the traditional clothes are made.
Right.
Yeah. They just buy the clothes and go to the salon, clothing salon.
And have them style it in their own fashion.
And they made these ones too. Wow.
When you're stopping through the market here, one thing you're going to need above all else is a piece of paper and something to write with. If you don't speak Mongolian, you're gonna have to have some way to write down and negotiate pricing, and this will help you tremendously. It'll really speed things up and get you cruising through the market. You can buy anything you could think of here, from a television to a generator to drugs to eagle heads to snakes to bear claws, Russian snacks, pretty much anything you can think of. You're gonna find it here. And you're gonna find it for less money because the products that are sold here are just like the products that they sell in the shops in town, except for these are all untaxed. Not only untaxed by the Mongolian government, but they're untaxed by China and Russia. Making this market a major trading route for products that cross from Europe to Asia and vice versa. Also, there is a bank here. It's a little known fact that it has a perfectly good exchange rate. It's about the same as the one in town. So you can change your money here too. You don't have to change your money at a bank in town. We've got pretty much everything we need. We're gonna stay warm. Got this camo hat here for $2. Got a pair of yak socks for $1.50. Got some snuff for, I don't know, it was like 30 cents or something. And a little snuff carrying case that we can bring to people for gifts and whatnot.
I'm only thinking I'm good.
Okay,
something weird. I don't
want to.
What is this
white thing? What is this white thing? Where did you get this?
She can get me some.
There's a couple of things that we couldn't pick up here. So while you're walking around the market, if there's stuff you can't find in the black market, there's the newer secondary black market we're about to enter right now. The new market has a much more organized layout, so it's more like a mini mall than it is an illegal market. And that's because, for some reason, I can't seem to find out how, both of these markets actually operate legally, yet untaxed.
That's great, yeah, that's a good thing.
Oh, hold on. Okay, so we're just coming out of the market here, and we're ready to jump back in traffic. This is about as good as traffic gets here. The rest of the day, it's pretty much blocked up, but for a couple of hours, it gets moving, and it can even affect just walking down the street because, as you can see, they just kind of stop. Thank you.